God save the king.
Whence camest thou, worthy thane?
From Fife, great king, where the Norwegian banners flout the sky and fan our people cold. Norway himself, with terrible numbers, assisted by that most disloyal traitor, the Thane of Cawdor, began a dismal conflict, till that Bellona's bridegroom, brave Macbeth, confronted him with self-comparisons, point against point, rebellious arm against arm, curbing his lavish spirit, and to conclude, the victory fell on us.
Great happiness.
That now, Sweno, the Norway's king, craves composition. Nor would we deign him burial of his men till he disbursed at said Comis Inch $10,000 to our general use.
No more that Thane of Cawdor shall deceive our bosom interest. Go, pronounce his present death, and with his former title greet Macbeth.
I'll see it done.
What he hath lost, noble Macbeth hath won.
Who's here?
The king hath happily received, Macbeth, the news of thy success.
We are sent to give thee from our royal master thanks.
And for an earnest of a greater honor, he bade me from him call thee Thane of Cawdor, in which addition hail most worthy thane, for it is thine.
What, can the devil speak true?
The Thane of Cawdor lives. Why do you dress me in borrowed robes?
Who was the Thane lives yet, but under heavy judgment bears that life which he deserves to lose. Whether he was combined with those of Norway, or did line the rebel with hidden help and vantage, or that with both he labored in his country's rack, I know not. But treason's capital, confessed and proved, have overthrown him.
Glamis and Thane of Cawdor. The greatest is behind. Thanks for your pains. Do you not hope your children shall be kings, when those that gave the Thane of Cawdor to me promised no less to them?
That trust at home might yet enkindle you unto the crown, besides the Thane of Cawdor. But 'tis strange. And oftentimes, to win us to our harm, the instruments of darkness tell us truths, win us with honest trifles to betray us in deepest consequence. Cousins, a word, I pray.
Two truths are told as happy prologues to the swelling act of the imperial theme. I thank you, gentlemen. This supernatural soliciting cannot be ill, cannot be good. If ill, why has it given me earnest of success, commencing in a truth? I am Thane of Cawdor. If good, why do I yield to that suggestion whose horrid image doth unfix my hair and make my seated heart knock at my ribs against the use of nature? Present fears are less than horrible imaginings. My thought, whose murder yet is but fantastical, shakes so my single state of man that function is smothered in surmise. And nothing is but what is not.
Look, our partner's rapt.
If chance will have me king, why, chance may crown me without my stir.
New honors come upon him like our strange garments, cleave not to their mold, but with the aid of use.
Come what? Come may. Time and the hour runs through the roughest day.
Worthy Macbeth, we stay upon your leisure.
Give me your favor, my dull brain was wrought with things forgotten. Kind gentlemen, your pains are registered where every day I turn the leaf to read them. Let's talk the king. Worthy Banquo, he is full so valiant, and in his commendations I am fed. It is a banquet to me. Let's after him whose care is gone before to bid us welcome. It is a peerless kinsman.
Good
Here's a knocking, indeed. A man with porter at Hell Gate, he should have called. Turning the key. Knock, knock, knock. Who's there? In the name of Beelzebub. Faith. Here's a farmer that hanged himself. On the expectation of plenty. Oh. Come in. Time server. Have napkins enough about you. Here you'll sweat for it. Knock, knock, who's there in the other devil's name?
Faith.
Here's an equivocator. Who can swear, eh? In both the scales, against either scale. Who committed treason enough, for God's sake, yet could not equivocate to heaven. Come in, equivocator. Knock, 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 who's there? Faith, here's an English tailor. You come here for stealing. Oh, yeah. Out of a French horse, Oh, ha, 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 ha. Come in, tailor. Here you may roast your goose. No, no, never a quiet. What are you? But this place is too cold for hell. I'll devil portrait no further. I had thought to have let in some of all professions that go the primrose way to the everlasting bonfire. Anon. Anon. I pray you, remember the porter. Oh.
Was it so late, friend, ere you went to bed, that you do lie so late?
Faith, sir, we was carousing till the second cock. And drink, sir, is a great provoker of three things.
Well, what three things does drink especially provoke?
Marry, sir, nose painting, sleep, and urine. Lectionary, sir. Drink provokes and unprovokes. Yes, it provokes a desire, but it takes away the performance. Yeah. Therefore, much drink may be said to be an equivocator. With lechery. It makes him and it mars him. It sets him on, it takes him off, it makes him stand to and not stand to. In conclusion, equivocates him in a sleep and giving him the lie leaves him.
I believe drink gave thee the lie last night.
That it did, sir. In the very throat of me.
Here lay Duncan, his silver skin laced with his golden blood.
Oh.
And his gashed stabs looked like a breach in nature for ruin's wasteful entrance. They're the murderers, steeped in the colors of their trade, their daggers unmannerly breached with gore. Who could refrain that had a heart to love, and in that heart courage to make his love known?
Volume of which time I have seen hours dreadful and things strange. But this sore night hath trifled former knowings.
Ah, good father, thou seest the heavens, as troubled with man's act, threatens his bloody stage. By the clock 'tis day, yet dark night strangles the travelling lamp. Is night's predominance, or the day's shame? That darkness does the face of earth entomb when living light should kiss it.
'Tis unnatural, even like the deed that's done.
How goes the world, sir? Now.
Why? See you not?
It's known who did this. More than bloody deed.
Those at Macbeth hath slain.
Alas, the day. What good could they pretend?
They were suborned. Malcolm and Donalbain, the king's two sons, are stolen away and fled, which puts upon them suspicion of the Dean.
Against nature, still. Thriftless ambition that will raven up thine own life's means. Then, 'tis most like the sovereignty will fall upon Macbeth.
He is already named and gone to Scone to be invested.
Where is Duncan's body?
Carried to Coombe Kill, the sacred storehouse of his predecessors and guardian of their bones.
Will you to Scone?
No, Cuz. I'll home to Fife.
Well, I will thither.
Well, may you see things well done there. Adieu. Lest our old robes sit easier than our new.
Farewell, Father.
God's benison go with you, and with those that would make good of bad and friends of foes.
Let every man be master of his time till 7 at night, to make society the sweeter welcome. We'll keep ourselves till supper time alone. Here had we now our country's honor, roofed were the graced person of our Banquo present, who may we rather challenge for unkindness than pity for mischance.
His absence, sir, lays blame upon his promise. Will please your highness grace us with your royal company?
The table's full.
Here's a place reserved, sir.
Well,
here, my good lord. What is that moves your highness?
Which of you have done this?
What, my good lord?
Thou canst not say I did it. Never shake my gory locks at me.
Gentlemen, rise. His highness is not well.
Sit, worthy friends. My lord is often thus, and hath been from his youth. Pray you keep seat. The fit is momentary. Upon a thought, he will again be well. If much you note him, you will offend him and extend his passion. Are you a man?
Aye, and a bold one, the day look on that, which might appall the devil.
Oh, proper stuff, this is a very painting of your fear. This is the air-drawn dagger which you said led you to Duncan. Oh, these flaws and starts. Impostors to true fear would well become a woman's story at a winter's fire authorized by her grandam. Shame itself! Why do you make such faces? When all's done, you look but on a stool.
Behold! Look! How shall you? What care I, thou canst not speak to? If charnel houses in our graves must send those that we bury back, our monuments shall be the maws of kites.
You are quite unmanned in folly.
If I stand here, I saw him!
Fie for shame!
The time has been that when the brains were out, the man would die, and there an end. But now they rise again with 20 mortal murders on their crowns and push us from our stools. This is more strange than such a murder is.
My worthy lord, your noble friends do lack you.
I do forget. Do not muse at me. My most worthy friends, I have a strange infirmity which is nothing to those that know me. Come, love and health to all. Then I'll sit. Give me some wine. Fill full. I drink to the general joy of the whole table and to our dear friend Banquo, whom we miss, would he were here. To all and him, we thirst. Let the earth hide thee! Thy bones are marrowless,
Thy blood is cold. Thou hast no speculation in those eyes which thou dost glare with.
Think of this, good Piers. Butter's a thing of custom. 'Tis no other. Only it spoils pleasure of the time.
What man dare I dare approach thou like the rugged Russian bear, the armed rhinoceros, the Hercan tiger? Take any shape but this, and my firm nerves will never tremble or be alive again, and dare me to the desert with thy sword. If trembling I inhabit, then protest with the baby of a girl. Hence, horrible shadow and real mockery. Being gone, I am a man again. Pray, you sit still.
You have displaced the mirth, broke the good meeting with most admired disorder.
Can such things be and overcome us like a summer's cloud without our special wonder? You make me strange even to the disposition that I owe, and now I think you can behold such sights and keep the natural ruby in your cheek when mine is blanched with fear.
What sights, my lord?
I pray you, speak not. He grows worse and worse. Question enrages him. At once, good night. Stand not upon the order of your going, but go at once.
Good night, and better health attend his majesty.
A kind good night. What had he done to make him fly the land?
You must have patience, madam.
He had none. His flight was madness. When our actions do not, our fears do make us traitors.
You know not whether it was his wisdom or his fear.
Wisdom? To leave his wife? To leave his babes, his mansion, and his titles? In a place from whence himself does fly? He loves us not. He wants the natural touch. For the poor wren, the most diminutive of birds, will fight her loved ones in her nest against the owl. All is the fear and nothing is the love. As little is the wisdom when the flight so runs against all reason.
My dearest cuz, I pray you, school yourself. But for your husband, he is noble, wise, judicious, and best knows the fits of the season. I dare not speak much further. But cruel are the times when we are traitors and do not know ourselves. When we hold rumor from what we fear, yet know not what we fear, but float upon a wild and violent sea each way and move. I take my leave of you. It shall not be long ere I'll be here again. Things, at the worst, will cease, or else climb upward to what they were before. My pretty cousin, blessing upon you.
Fathered he is, and yet he's fatherless.
I am so much a fool should I stay longer. It will be my disgrace and your discomfort. I take my leave. At once.
See who comes here.
My countryman.
My ever gentle cousin, welcome hither.
Good God, betimes remove the means that makes us strangers.
Sir, amen.
Stand Scotland where it did?
Alas. Poor country. Almost afraid to know itself. It cannot be called our mother, but our grave, where nothing, but who knows nothing, is once seen to smile. where sighs and groans and shrieks that rent the air are made not marked, where violent sorrow seems a modern ecstasy. The dead man's knell is there, scarce asked, for who? And good men's lives expire before the flowers in their caps, dying, or ere they sicken.
Relation too nice, and yet too true.
What's the newest grief?
That of an hour's age doth hiss the speaker. Each minute teems a new one.
How does my wife?
Why, well.
And all my children?
Well, too.
The tyrant has not battered at their peace.
No, they were well at peace. When I did leave them.
Be not a niggard of your speech. How goes it?
When I came hither to transport the tidings, which I have heavily borne, there ran a rumor of many worthy fellows that were out, which was to my belief witnessed the rather, for that I saw the tyrant's power afoot. Now is the time of help. Your eye in Scotland would create soldiers, make our women fight to doff their dire distresses.
Be at their comfort, we are coming thither, and with 10,000 men.
Would I could answer this comfort with the like. But I have words that should be howled out in the desert air where hearing would not latch them.
What concern they? The general cause, or is it a fee grief due to some single breast?
No mind that's honest, but in it shares some woe. Though the main part pertains to you alone.
If it be mine, keep it not from me.
Quickly, let me have it. Let not your ears despise my tongue forever, which shall possess them with the heaviest sound that ever yet they heard.
I guess at it.
Your castle is surprised, your wife and babes savagely slaughtered. To relate the manner whereon the quarry of these murdered deer, to add the death of you.
Merciful heaven. Give sorrow words. The grief that does not speak whispers the o'erfraught heart and bids it break.
My children too?
Wife, children, servants, all that can be found.
And I must be from thence. My wife killed too?
I have said.
Be comforted. Let's make us medicines of our great revenge to cure this deadly grief.
He has no children.
All my little ones.
Did you say all?
Oh. Hell kite. All?
All my pretty chickens. And their dam. At one fell swoop.
Dispute it. Like a man.
I shall do so. But I must also feel it as a man. I cannot but remember such things were that were most precious to me. Did heaven look on and would not take their part? Sinful Macduff, they were all struck for thee. Naught that I am, not for their own demerits, but for mine fell slaughter on their souls. Heaven rest them now.
Be this the whetstone of your sword. Let grief convert to anger. Blunt not the heart, enrage it.
I could play the woman with mine eyes and brag it with my tongue. The gentle heavens cut short all intermission.
Front to front bring thou this fiend of Scotland and myself. Within my sword's length set him. If he scape, heaven forgive him too.
This tune goes manly. Come, go we to the king. Our power is ready, our lack is nothing but our leave. Macbeth is ripe for shaking. Receive what cheer you may. The night is long that never finds the day.
The English power is near, led on by Malcolm.
Near Burnham Wood shall we well meet them.
What does the tyrant?
Great Dunsinane he strongly fortifies.
Some say he's mad.
Others, that lesser hate him, do call it valiant fury. But for certain he cannot buckle his distempered cause within the belt of rule.
Now does he find his secret murders sticking on his hands.
Now, minutely revolts upbraid his faith breach. Those he commands move only in command, nothing in love.
Now does he find his title hang loose about him, like a giant's robe upon a dwarfish thief.
Who then can blame his pestered senses to recoil and start, when all that is within him does condemn itself for being there?
Well, march we on. We learn no other but the confident tyrant keeps still in Dunsinane, and will endure our setting down before it.
It is his main hope. What wood is this before us?
The wood of Burnham.
Let every soldier hew him down a bough and bear it before him. Thereby shall we shadow the numbers of our host, and make discovery in report of us.
It shall be done.
Advance the war.
Advance!
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 Hang out our banners on the outward walls!
Enter, sir, the castle.
I would the friends we lack were safe arrived. Macduff is missing.
Hail, King, for so thou art. The time is free. Hail, King of Scotland.
Hail, King of Scotland.
We shall not spend a large expense of time before we reckon with your several loves and make us even with you. What's more to do? As calling home our exiled friends abroad that fled the snares of watchful tyranny, producing forth the cruel ministers of this dead butcher and his fiend-like queen, who, 'tis thought, by self and violent hands, took off her life. This, and what needful else that calls upon us by the grace of grace, we shall perform in measure, time, and place. So thanks to all, at once, and to each one, whom we invite to see us crowned at Scone.